Hi, my name is Brian Norton, and I'm with the InData Project at Easter Seals Crossroads. And today we're going to be talking about how to make lists using our Amazon Alexa app. And so every Alexa account comes with two default lists that you can add items to. The first would be shopping, and the second would be your to-do list. So those are default ones, but you can add or archive other lists depending on what you're doing day in and day out or over time. And so let's take a look a little bit at what it looks like to be able to add lists to Amazon Alexa. So I'm going to go ahead and open up my app. Once I'm in my app, I've got those two lists right away in the very top part there. It says to-do and shopping, but I want to go a little bit deeper and get into some of the background settings. So I'm going to click on the more button in the bottom right-hand corner. We're going to go up to lists and notes. And that's where you're going to see shopping and to-do. Again, those two default ones that come on every Alexa account. And then I also have this option to be able to create my own list. So let's talk about creating lists first. So I'm going to click on create list. It's going to give me the option to put in a list name. And I'm going to go ahead and say work, because I have a lot of things to do at work. This being one of them, create videos for Swap and how to use the Alexa app. So I'm going to go ahead and create one called work, and I'm going to go ahead and hit my enter key, and then that gets added. I'm going to go back with the back button at the top left-hand corner just to see and show you it's got two default ones, shopping and to-do, and then any other list I create gets put under my list. And then I can click on these to be able to add items, take items off, do those kinds of things. So I'm going to go to my to-do list. And I've got a bunch of different things that I need to do. I need to pick up milk from the store. I need to take my medication before I go to bed. I need to call my son. Lots of different things for me to do. If I add these, in order to add them, you'll see the add item button at the very top. So if I click on that, it's just opening up a box and I can say, you know what? Stop by mom's today to say hi. And I'm going to go ahead and just say, hit my enter key or add item. Stop by mom's to say hi. And then I'm going to hit my enter key. It's going to get added into that for me. If I want to check one, maybe I did stop by mom's today, I can go ahead and take that off my list by checking the box, and it gets down into a completed items area down below on the very bottom. And once it's in that completed items, let's say tomorrow I've got to do it again. I want to go ahead and do that again. I'll go ahead and uncheck it. It's going to go right back up into my overall list. It's something that I need to do. So I can check, goes away, gets put into my completed items. I can uncheck it if it's something that I need to do, you know, next week or the week after as well. It keeps a list of those completed items for us. A couple other things you can do with this. If I come back over here, I can simply, I'm going to go to my home area, and I can add anything to these different lists I've created. So I could say, Alexa, add eggs to my shopping list, or Alexa, what's on my shopping list? All of those different things can be done. And so let's take a look a little bit using our voice to be able to add things to the different lists we've created. And again, we've created a to-do list, a shopping list, and a work list. And so I'm going to hit the tap to talk to Alexa button. Alexa, add eggs to my shopping list.
Eggs add to your shopping list.
It's going to show me what's there. I'm going to go ahead and click the exit button. Click on that tap to talk to Alexa button again. Alexa, what's on my shopping list?
You have 8 items on your shopping list. Here are the 5 most recent: eggs, chocolate, salsa, and butter. Would you like to hear your last 3 items?
No.
Okay.
My voice is cutting out on me just a little bit there with the Alexa voice, but you can see that it'll actually read through that shopping list, and I can actually scroll through it as well. I can also come down here and I can click the manage button. It's going to bring me back out to my list, and I can go into shopping and kind of see all of those different there, right there. And as I shop, I can mark them as something that I've gotten. And so it's real simple and easy to use to be able to kind of go down there and and see what I have on my list and to be able to check those things as things that I've gotten or things that are still needed. So I'll take off butter and I'll take off chocolate. And there they go.
And that's your tech tip for this week. My name is Brian Norton with the InData Project at Easter Seals Crossroads in Indiana.